Begin on all fours. Inhale and come into a back bend. Exhale into a hunch. Inhale into a back bend. Exhale into a hunch. Inhale into a back bend. Exhale into a hunch. Inhale into a back bend and hold it here for a couple of breaths. Feel the whole spine contribute to that back bend. Exhale, come into a hunch. Hold it here for a little bit and feel the arms and the legs help dome the spine. Broaden the muscles of the back from the center. Feeling the top of the head and the tip of the tailbone as if they were making a circle. Inhale into a back bend again. From the back bend, keeping the sitting bones lifted, come to a bent leg downward dog. Lift the sit bones and feel the depth of the groins. Feel the length of the waist reaching all the way down into your arms, bending the legs to whatever degree necessary to get the full length of your spine. Begin to straighten the legs, but keep way up on the toes so that you lift the sitting bones as high as possible. Straight legs giving traction to your spine. Reach down through your arms. Very slowly begin to bring the heels toward the ground. Lengthen the heels as far away from the toes as possible. Get the thighs to pull back, giving full traction of the spine into the reach of the arms. Let your spine be supple. Bend the legs and come back to a neutral spine on all fours. Slowly bring the hips back. Bend the arms and begin to scoop between the arms to lie on the ground. With the legs extended fully, lift the head and the chest to look forward. Firm your shoulder blades into your back and move your chest even more forward from your grounded legs. Elongate your spine. Slowly release back to the ground. Hands under your head. Legs are still strongly extended. Feel them press together as your nervous system is at ease. Lift your right leg, not lifting it too high, mainly reaching it. Slowly release it. Inhale and lift the left leg, extending it, reaching it, elongating the waist. Slowly release that leg. Right leg again, extending and lifting. Both legs are extending strongly. Lift the chest forward and up. Release that leg. Lift the left leg in the same way. The arms are helping pull you forward, getting the full length of the spine without hardness. Release down. Lift the right leg one more time, this time holding it a little longer. Don't lift it too high, mainly concentrate on the length and the breath in all the muscles of the back. Slowly release. Lift the left leg again with the full elongation of both legs. With the left leg lifting, feel the muscles of the back working and broaden them from the spine. Every part of the spine working evenly. Slowly release that leg. Place both arms down by your side. Lift the legs, the head, the chest into a locust pose. Hands off the ground. Fully lengthen the legs. Move the chest from those legs and lift. Feel the back of the legs working. The buttocks muscles working. The lower back, middle back, upper back alive and strong. slowly release back down. Place the hands in a push-up position. Slowly move into cobra pose, weaving the spine back and forth. Illuminate your entire spine. You don't have to straighten the arms this first time. Just feel the legs helping the full arc of the spine. Slowly weave yourself back down. Take a couple of breaths, resting on the ground with long legs. Come into cobra pose again. This time, if you can, straighten the arms. From those straight arms, widen your chest. Feel the support of the arms underneath the collarbones. Lift your collarbones and begin to look up. From cobra pose, take downward dog. Slowly lengthening your spine, get the full length of your waist. Bring your right foot forward into a lunge. Let the left knee come to the ground. Place your fingertips to the ground. Let the arms help you lift your chest as your sacrum presses forward. The front heel and the back ankle are pressing into the ground. Come into a bent leg standing forward bend. Let your spine release. Breathe. Right foot back to a lunge. Drop the right knee to the ground. Left knee moves forward. Deep lunge. Sacrum presses forward. Chest and head lifting. Breathe. Return to a bent leg standing forward bend. Let the spine release over those bent legs. Keep feeling like the lower back is getting longer and wider as gravity takes you down over those legs. Slowly now, from the full release of the spine, begin to extend the legs, letting go of the hamstrings and the calf muscles. Let the muscles of your entire back body be wide. Begin to bend the legs to powerful pose and feel the whole spine make a huge arc from the sacrum to the fingertips. Thigh bones drop into the hamstrings. Shin bones move forward. Feet plant deeply. Elongate all the way through the spine. One long curve. Slowly begin to straighten the legs into a standing back bend. Strong legs, long waist, extended arms. Come into mountain pose. Feel how easy and supported your spine is from your feet and your legs. The arms help to support the upper chest. Triangle pose with the blocks. Take a wide stride. Left foot in, right foot out. Raise your arms out to the side. Exhale, come down to the block with your right hand. With your left hand onto your sacrum, begin to slowly turn the spine. Turn the chest. Keep elongating the spine from those strong legs and the press of the bottom arm. Extend the left arm up. Feel from one arm to the next the openness of your chest. From the length and strength of your legs, elongate your side waist. Inhale and come on up. Turn your right foot in, left foot out. Inhale, on the exhalation, triangle pose to the left, left hand to the block. Right hand onto the sacrum. Make sure you have the full length of both sides of your waist. Support the openness of your chest from the strength of your legs. Now take the right arm up. Feel the extension of both arms supporting the chest and elongating the chest from the waist. Move the buttocks flesh down through the back heel. Inhale and come back up. Turn your left foot in, right foot out for a side angle pose. Bend the front leg towards 90 degrees. Place the hand on the block, the left hand on the sacrum. Again, support the length of the spine. Open your chest. Press down into the block. Press down with your feet into the ground. Extend the spine and open your chest. Take your top arm over and elongate the bottom waist as you reach the top arm. Breathe. Inhale and come back up. Right foot in, left foot out. Bend your front leg to 90 degrees and keep the strength of the back leg. Bring your left hand to the block, right hand onto the sacrum. Begin to lengthen the spine, especially the lower back, as you turn. Breathe. The buttocks flesh moves towards the back heel. The lower ribs rise away. Take the top arm up and let the top arm help you reach the bottom waist and deepen the hip creases. Elongate the spine completely as you turn and yet feel the suppleness. Inhale and come back up. Place a chair on your mat. Face the back of the chair. Take your right leg up into tree pose, holding onto the chair with the left hand. Take your right hand to the top of the right thigh and press the thigh down. From there, lengthen both sides of your waist. The buttocks flesh releases from the lower back. The lower back and the chest rise from the pelvis. Maintain the suppleness of the lower back as you lengthen the waist. Come back to mountain pose. Plant the feet. Take the left leg into tree pose. Right hand holds onto the chair. With the left hand, press the left thigh into the hamstring. Drop the thigh even more as your waist elongates into the chest. Simple breath. Ground the legs. Lengthen the chest away from the pelvis. Again, a long waist without hardness of the lower back muscles. Back to mountain pose. Face your chair. Take your left leg back to a lunge. Bring the right leg to 90 degrees as much as possible. Ground your left heel. Push down on the backrest of the chair to lengthen the spine and lift the chest. Ground as much as you can into your back leg. If it feels like it's ungrounded, straighten the front leg a little bit. Use the chair again to hoist the chest even higher. It's important while you do this not to tense the muscles of the back, but to broaden them wide from the spine. Bring the back leg forward to mountain pose. Now bring the right leg back to a lunge. Warrior one. Ground both heels from the strength of both legs and the press of the arms. Elongate the spine into a beautiful back bend. Open your chest. Feel the length of your waist rising from the floor of your pelvis. Use the arms and legs to support your heart. Breathe easy. Bring the back leg to mountain pose. Lie on your back with your legs bent. Rest the lower back. Feel the ease of your spine, the vibration of your spine, feeling the muscles of the back release. Slowly do a sit-up. Lift the head and the chest. Hold on to the back of the legs if necessary, or extend the fingers beside your legs. Round the back, using the abdominal muscles as they hollow. Slowly lower back down. Bring your legs into a cross-legged position. Draw them towards your chest. Take your arms between the shins and lift your head and chest into a sit-up. Move your legs towards your armpits as you round the back even more. Breathe easy. Strong abdominal muscles. Support and round the back. Slowly come back down. Put the other leg on top. One more time, lift the head and chest. Engage the abdominal muscles, the tuck of the tailbone, as you hollow the belly and the groins. Round the back. Draw the armpits towards the shins. Lift the head. Slowly lower back down. Bring the knees together. Take the left armpit towards the right knee. From the flexing of the feet, draw the knees also towards the armpit, strengthening the abdominal muscles. Breathe. Come up a little higher. Lift the head, using the arms to support the lift of the chest. Slowly come back down. Bring the right armpit towards the left knee, slowly lifting. Flex the feet and draw the legs closer to the armpit. The whole body is working to create this fold. Come a little bit higher from the ground, and then slowly release back to the ground. Cross your shins again and rock on your spine forward and backwards. A couple of rocks and roll right on up to a simple cross-legged position. Place the soles of your feet together, hands behind your hips, and take cobbler's pose with a little bit of a back bend. Elongate your spine from the heels pressing into each other. Feel the legs come under the pelvis. Lift your chest. Come back to cobbler's pose. Now hold on to your ankles. Close your eyes for a moment. Scan your spine. Breathe.